Welcome back, everyone. I'm JayBarino, and this is Starcraft Subjection, a custom campaign for Starcraft II. We are on Mission 7, the second-to-last mission, another macro map. I rather like this mission because I think that the doodad placements and the terrain is rather cool. I really love the opening cinematic. And I also really like the mission before this one, too. And I say this just to emphasize that coming off of Missions 4 and 5, where I felt I was very negative, and I realize now, I think the reasoning for that is because I've already played through this, so as I play this, it's not really my first gut reactions to the map, so it's a lot easier for me to be very nitpicky and get kind of pissy about things where I normally wouldn't if it was my first playthrough. If I were to go back and play some maps again of other campaigns, I have a feeling I might be a little more, I'd pay way more close attention to detail and, you know, nitpicky. So I hate to be so negative early on in this campaign, but I guess it is what it is. Anyway, I have to emphasize, I do like these last three maps quite a bit. This one's, again, I like that the macro missions probably more so than the micro missions of this campaign. I don't know, I really did like Mission 1, though. Mission 1 was probably my favorite, so I take that back, I suppose. Let's get going. Gonna continue on hard. Kinda curious to know what the differences will be on hard versus normal.
I suggest a truce. It is the only way any of us will survive the coming onslaught of the Terrans.
We have already been robbed of our objective upon this planet, to secure the crystals. We have no need to aid you now.
There are other resource caches in existence. We shall take what is already mined of the crystals and leave. You can report back to Shakuras and return in victory instead of defeat.
A tempting offer. If you do not expect me to take your word for it.
Of course not. I shall join minds with you in the Kala. We both know that in this mind link, no Protoss can lie.
That's convenient.
After we defeat the Terrans, we will take the crystals that have already been extracted and leave this place without further aggression.
So be it. We will hold you to your vow.
Alright, so now we're playing as Logan's forces again, so we are just gonna clean up the Zerg base and take it. I've emphasized this before, I really like how you play as different factions in this campaign. I think that's really important. You play as the Daylon Protoss, you play as the Annalene, you play as the Terran forces. Really, really, really cool, and it really harkens back to the old school Brood War missions, where you had many different perspectives of how the story was told, regardless of whether you would consider someone shitty or not, you would have to play as them. Alright, finish this up. And then we'll wait for the creep to recede and take this base.
Gentlemen, thanks for meeting me. Son of a bitch, I thought we killed you.
You are not the first to say that.
Oh, I don't doubt that, but I just might be the first to get a second shot at it.
Or maybe you got that the other way around.
Parker, you disappoint me. It's not too late to change your mind. You're heavily outnumbered.
Prospector! This resource cache is rightfully ours! Your aggression here is unsanctioned!
On the contrary, I am well within my rights as a law-abiding Kelmorian prospector. This planet was under the protection of the Combine before you invaded.
You will find that the populace will not be any more receptive to you than they are to us. If you think that you will be seen as a hero for routing us, you are severely mistaken.
He shall do no such thing. We have vast fleets waiting in reserve, ready to
Spectre Logan, I shall give you one last chance to recant and withdraw your forces from this squadron before we pulverize you and your warriors into atoms.
That's one idea. Know what I think? I think you gentlemen already blew your load fighting each other, and if you had the strength to defeat me, you'd have attacked by now. Leave, or prepare to be destroyed. It makes no difference to me.
Your greed shall be your downfall, human. This time, you have grasped too far.
All right, men. It's just like I told you. This is the biggest resource cache in the quadrant. The warring Protoss factions here are weak, and I don't need to remind you that Kaderan Crystal practically grows on trees over here. We've landed on the opposite side of the Danaya River in order to set up camp safely. Once we have distributed all the munitions and set up the supply lines, our Hercules dropships can facilitate our invasion. Before this day is over, you will all be rich men.
Cool. Okay, now, I like this. When I say this, I mean, I feel like Gradius did this very purposefully, where he had that cutscene there, so now all the creep has receded, so you didn't just have to wait. So I think that, like, having a lengthy cutscene there served two purposes, which is, I think, really, really smart. Okay, so let's just go ahead and land our shit. I think we have a starport here, too. So in my uncommentated playthrough, I made... What did I end up doing? Mass battlecruisers, I think. Now, the thing in this map is that the enemy sort of leaves you alone for the most part, or at least that's what I seem to remember. They just sort of left me alone. So I think what I might do is just build up and do the same thing again, but I might be able to do it a little faster, because I think I'm... It's kind of like the last mission. I don't know, I feel like I'm slightly better player than I was, so maybe I can make this happen. But with all these Hercules, I'll probably have to destroy those to free up supplies eventually. Okay, so let's just... We're going to have to make a bunch of depots. Now, the only thing about this mission that I have bad to say is I feel like it's slightly a shame that over in this area, over to the left, we never have to go over there. There's some cool terrain over there that's really neat, but unfortunately you're never able to really see it because there's no reason to go over there. There's like a power plant that connects to this little city over here. I think this is cool. It kind of shows like actual buildings on the planet. There is a, looks like there's actually an expansion over here. I might take that. That looks like a good expansion actually, so maybe I do have to come over here. But as you go further over, there's like a shipyard sort of place. It's really neat. Okay, so I'm just gonna have to make a lot of depots here. Kind of messed up my placement, but that's okay. And yeah, eventually I'm gonna get into battlecruisers. So I should probably just start my gas mining now. In fact, I will do that, and I believe we'll use a science vessel. There's a base to take kind of up in this direction, so I'll just, you know, drop that down and make a shit ton of supply depots and missile turrets to defend myself. So yeah, like this area here, it's really neat. You can see that these power lines here, like they trace back to the city. It's like a really neat setup, and it's too bad that there's really no reason to ever end up over there, but that's okay. We'll set those up. But yeah, I really like the way that looks. Here's the other base. I think if you drop a base here, they actually start attacking up there. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to take this base early, and then I'm just going to put a bunch of missile turrets down to defend it. Because I have a lot of... I have a decent amount of income right now. Again, it's really just freeing up supply in order to defend myself. So let's take the battle cruisers and go on up here, and we'll keep a science vessel in case they drop Dark Templar on me, which I'm almost certain they're going to do. And maybe I'll take this quickly. I don't know where they're going to attack comparatively. There's random bunkers over here, and I don't know what they're for. Maybe I can, like, commandeer them. That would be neat. Okay, so let's go ahead and throw some more guys mining over here. So as you can see, the problem here is that I don't have enough income. I don't have enough income for SCVs. So, yeah, what are these? I don't think I can take those. That's okay. Colonists. So I think this is, like, the actual city that, like, I would say Parker is from. I'm not entirely sure, though. Let's take two tanks and move them up. I think with these Marines, Medics, and Wraiths, I'll be good to defend myself while I wait for my income to sort of pick up. And with Mules and such, I'm good as well. So let's keep going with the depots. They give you so many Hercules at the beginning, it really throws your supply so far up. Okay, they are actually dropping on me. That's a lot of stuff. When I played this mission originally, I didn't really recall getting attacked really at all, but now they are dropping on me, which is great. I'm pleased, because I remember on normal, I felt like this mission was a little too easy. But, not to the point where I was, like, unhappy. Okay, there's a scout over here. I'd really rather not lose this science vessel, but I think I'm going to. We'll see. All right, now let's start dropping mules and get this all set up. Once we get some, okay, where do I want to put these tanks? Maybe over here. Once I get some missile turrets set up, I'm in good shape. I can also make perdition turrets, which would be good on the drop points. Okay, so again, I'm really just focused on... Let's see, I have both of these selected, but I can't drop mules where I wanted to. Interesting. Okay, that's fine. Now I have some free supply. Eventually, I think I'm probably just going to end up killing my own Hercules transports just to... You know, free up supply. We're gonna want to do structure armor and
not enough minerals.
Probably the Neo Steel frame, and also pretty much all of these, all three of these, I'm gonna get. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and throw some SCVs. Even though I'm short on minerals, I want to get my gas income going really, really quick because I really, really want the fastest gas possible to get more to just get more battlecruisers quickly, so I'm just going to get my infrastructure going. Might as well throw down a fusion core now. And then I'm going to need double armories, too. And with mass battlecruisers, we're just going to smash the Protoss. See, I have both of these selected, but I can't drop mules. I think the problem is that this command center is technically different than this command. You see mules is here, as opposed to down here. It's like these are technically different units somehow. I don't understand how, but they are. Okay, so let's make some turrets, because it seems like this is kind of the area where they drop in.
Not enough minerals.
Okay, we're going to need more turrets here, too. Though our battlecruisers here will help us defend pretty well. Our science vessels... Okay, yeah, we do have the nano repair. That's great, so we can keep our battlecruisers kind of topped off. Let's go ahead and set up our other stuff. We'll drop a perdition turret here. Again, I don't want the enemies walking into my mineral line, then my own tanks will end up killing my stuff, so let's keep dropping mules, and I have to make sure I select these separately so that I can drop mules from both. Alright, supply depots are good. Let's get a behemoth reactor, and then once I get enough SCVs going, then I will... Yeah, get them as they drop in. Run wraiths. Okay, so now we have a few different... wraiths. Okay, now get in here, wraiths. Now run away, wraiths. Okay, so I need to pay way more attention to defense. Now I need some turrets up here. I just need turrets in a few different areas. This is looking good, though. We can get a few marauders, too. That'll help against all those stalkers. The scouts, though, can be problematic, but they don't really do that much damage. So I'm not that frightened of them. We need more SCVs up here in general. Alright, so let's take this guy, and we'll make turrets up here. And perdition turrets kind of scattered around for wherever they drop. The perdition turrets will be able to take a lot of damage, which is what I need them to do. So let's do armory and armory 2, and then get back to mining. We're going to take a few of these SCVs and move them on up here so that as we make SCVs at both bases, they'll be evened up. In terms of how many workers are on each side, but I'm way ahead on gas, which is exactly what I needed. Let's go ahead and pull one SCV off to repair these wraiths. I'm going to use these wraiths to slowly kill off my own Hercules transports because I would like the supply there. Okay, so lots of turrets, lots of perdition, and then perdition turrets as well. So this is very similar to Mission 3, where they can only attack by dropping on you. So if you have a general idea of where they're going to drop, then you just layer it in turrets, and they won't. And rather than dropping when they get in range of the turrets, they'll just keep flying over to where they end up wanting to go and get killed, which is fantastic. Concussive shells, I'll just queue up both of those because those are great upgrades, and we can start our ship upgrades right away. Now, this is Wings of Liberty when the upgrades were still separated, so take that into consideration. And then even more turrets here, and then another more perdition turrets. I just want to get this as defended as possible. I'm probably going to get a couple more tanks, maybe just one or two tanks up here. Okay, I'm feeling pretty good here. And I might go ahead and get... I might get another science vessel, too. None of these are science vessel upgrades, are they? No. Okay. We'll get a third science vessel. I'm going to get those a little earlier because they need research time complete to charge up their energy. So let's get one, two. Abandoned ship. What do we got up here? Okay, so they're dropping in my mineral line, so my own tanks might end up killing some of my my stuff, but I think we're good. Get over here. Okay, so it all paid off. I'm gonna make some medics and keep them in that mineral line to heal up my SCVs. But that worked out pretty darn well, I'd say. I knew they would be doing that. Let's make a perdition turret right there. And another turret there. Okay, so let's do structure armor, high sec auto tracking. That's probably all we really need. Okay, so let's get three more starports. Let's wait until I can afford them. And then we'll start making a crazy amount of battlecruisers. Again, I'm still not really saturated to the point where I'd want to be. Okay, you keep mining. I'd say this is well defended. Down here, yeah, this is fine, I'd say, overall. Get perdition turrets here. Perdition turrets, just a cheap way to... I mean, they're not really the best in terms of dealing damage, but the whole idea is if they're dropping in this area, they'll stop to attack these stupid perdition turrets first, which is really, really important. So now let's do... kill all of these. Sorry, Hercules. In fact, I could probably use one to kind of scout the coast, so attack this one, this, and this. And then you, Hercules, just sort of scout out around here. I mean, it's going to die when it flies over the coast, surely, but, I mean, that's okay. Okay, looking good. I might take this base over to the left, but I don't know if they're going to drop on it, so I'll just go ahead and take it and see what happens.
If I die, I kill you.
Okay, and then... oh, you're definitely going to die, dude. Sorry. And then, more starports. Okay, we're going to hotkey those to two. Here they come again, it looks like. Looking good, looking good. This is exactly what needed to happen. How are these upgrades looking? Great. Cool. So, pretty much over here is like the Daylam base, where there are High Templar, Dark Templar. And then over here is the Annalene base, where they have Carriers and Colossi. So there, and Dragoons. So, and then over here would be Stalkers. It's kind of an interesting mix. Okay, so now we've got a lot of, come on, there we go. So now we have a bunch of minerals, we got a huge income. Once these are done, we're gonna queue up a ton of battlecruisers. Looking real good with, I would say looking really good on defense here. Now, having played this before, I had a general idea how this would go, but if this was the first time, and on hard mode, those attacks are pretty challenging, so I think the attacks are just right for this level. Again, I find that Mission 5, the difficulty was very out of sorts, which is probably my biggest problem with it, and I think if you could make the difficulty of Mission 6 the difficulty of Mission 5, and make the difficulty of this mission the difficulty of Mission 6, and then take the difficulty of Mission 5 and make it the difficulty of this mission. So basically reorganizing the difficulty so that it felt like it was scaling up more. That would make this feel a little more balanced, I'd say. It's very hard to... So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh yeah, battlecruisers. If that was the case, then this would feel like it flowed a little more, but the difficulty of Mission 5 was just so high. And again, I don't mind that. I think the crazy big Ultralisk Corruptor attacks were just kind of like a fuck you, like there's nothing you can do to counter this. But other than that, I felt the difficulty was good. I mean, there's nothing wrong with having a challenging difficulty. The biggest issue that I had with it was, again, it was just sort of thrown in there, and it was like, holy shit, like out of nowhere, challenging. Okay, so we'll add this guy, and we'll just start throwing mules down here. So it's like if you build an orbital command, it's like the orbital command from Wings of Liberty when you had researched orbital command in the armory, which means that like you build the command center and suddenly it's orbital command. So I think the buttons are in like a different spot. I don't really know. I don't understand. In fact, I'm going to make this one a planetary fortress. I might make this one a planetary fortress too, just in case. And with my extra money, I will make turrets just in case. And then perdition turrets, I suppose. It's kind of overboard, but whatever. Mostly just need refineries, so we'll get those set up. Okay. Okay, and then we'll queue up plus three, and once plus three is done, we'll probably have the battlecruisers that we want. Sounds good. Now, some of these Marines are taking up supply, and I don't really need them. I also want some more science vessels. How many do we have? We have 10. That's probably enough to win, honestly. I'm going to get two more science vessels. Send them on up, because the more science vessels, the better, because they can heal. And then let's go ahead and throw these SCVs in here, and now we've got a nice amount of income. Yep, so now they are attacking over here, but we do have a planetary. I don't know if that's going to be enough. Probably won't be enough. But now I know that they're attacking from this direction. We could mass repair this. I don't know if it'll be enough. Okay, mass repair. In fact, this might do it. This is great, actually. This is using my gas, though, which is unfortunate, but I really want to retain this base. You three get back to mining. Mule, you get back to mining. Okay, and then I guess Perdition turrets over here.
Yeah, whatever.
It all worked out. That's great. I can't believe that was effective. Okay, so you guys get back to mining gas, and then you just finish repairing this.
Bad news.
And once that's done, mine. Okay, great. So, I think we're good. We can make, I don't know, however many more battlecruisers. 1, 2, 3 more. I'd like to make one more, and then it'll be time to attack. The attacks seem to be coming a little more frequently now, which is good, but I'm mostly prepared. I'm surprised there are no Dark Templar or High Templar mixed in. If High Templar were dropped with the ability to storm me, kind of like, again, Mission 5, that this would be a lot more challenging. Again, I feel like the challenge of this one is about equal to the last mission. But overall, I'm happy with it. And it's fun. You get to mess around with Terran again, which I like. Okay, science vessels, you just follow. And I think I'm going to go ahead and start on the right and just sweep the map from right to left. And then these battlecruisers, once they're done, will catch up. And then I can rebuild pretty easily. We'll get, why not, Neo Steel Frame. I didn't make any bunkers, which is strange of me. But, I mean, bunkers means you have to put Marines inside of them, which means that they're not as effective. Or not. They're very effective. The issue is that they... this and this. The issue is that they it takes supply. That's the biggest thing, in my opinion, is it takes up that supply. So I'm going to save my Yamatos. I mean, I can use Yamatos across the river. You know what? This is not the mass recall mod, which means that Yamato is way, way, way more responsive, which is great. Here comes their next attack, but I'm going to catch it as they go over. Haha! And see, they just come... Oh, they do drop over here. So when they start getting attacked, they do end up coming down this way. Okay, well, I caught them en route, which is great. And there we go. Good stuff. We have Iridia, but we don't have EMP, because EMP is no longer... Let's get three more battle... Oh, we don't have any more supply. Because EMP is no longer on the science vessel like it is in the original StarCraft. It is only on ghosts. Okay, and let's just continue onwards. There's going to be a lot of cannons here and shit like that, but I think with the science vessels, we're going to be in really good shape. This one, again, it's like having medics. It's awesome. Absolutely awesome. Though their energy, I think their energy to healing is not nearly as good. Now, because we're not dropping, we don't have to worry about Colossus. That's probably my biggest thing, is you don't have to worry about Colossus. And not to mention, we can Yamato... We can Yamato carriers, we can Yamato scouts, and we can Yamato High Templar. Whereas if we came in with tanks, we'd have a pretty challenging landing there. I don't know if I've destroyed all these cannons, so I'm not going to. I'm just going to go for their bases, and then if I have to, I'll clean up the cannons along the coast. I know in the last mission, I didn't have to destroy every building. I only had to destroy, I think, only their production buildings. I'm not 100% sure. Can I get over this? Yeah, I can. I love how the units, like, move upwards towards the camera as they go over those sort of cliffs. It's really neat. Okay, and here we go. I can just auto-attack, but how fun is this? I love battlecruisers in StarCraft 2. They just have such a fun, cool attack animation. I'm just going to be on the lookout for High Templar, because those will do a lot of extra damage to me. But for now, we're good. I don't know if the attacks in this are spawned or not. I think they've been spawned in every mission, so I'm going to assume they're spawned. As you can see, they're a Dark Templar, but I can see them because I have science vessels. Okay, so, like, the bases here are not nearly as well defended as the Zerg bases in Mission 5. I keep going back to Mission 5 because I feel like I need to rectify the fact that I was so critical of it, but it was just such a long, tedious mission, and that's probably my least favorite kind of mission in general, a la Enslavers. So, overall, maybe I'm just not good enough. That's, you know, that's probably the biggest thing, is maybe I'm just not a good enough player to play on what Gradius considers the hard difficulty, and that's, you know, that's my problem. And overall, I think I have a lot more positive things to say about this campaign than negative. So that's important to remember, too, because I don't want anyone to think that I'm being unfair. A lot of this is, I'm the one who's playing, so I'm the one who's commentating. My opinion is not the end-all be-all, though, so... You know, I like to discuss in the comments different things about different campaigns that people liked or don't liked or anything like that. And never do I think that objectively my opinion is, you know, matters more. And if I think that something about a campaign, then that's necessarily the right, objectively correct thing about that campaign. You know, never, absolutely never. And I know a lot of campaign makers like to hear criticisms. And I know Gradius, I've read a lot of what he's written on forums and stuff, on SC Legacy and on SC2 Mapster. And he's very open to criticism, and he has, you know, acknowledged a lot of what he sees as flaws about his campaigns, and I've seen his advice saying, if you're a campaign creator, if you're a perfectionist, you're probably not going to have a good time, because if you're a perfectionist, you're going to spend forever in alpha and beta stages and never going to release your campaign. So the fact that someone can release a campaign and acknowledge its flaws is really, really admirable, and a lot of campaign creators are like that. A lot of campaign creators like getting criticism, as long as you're not a dick about it. I mean, I can just assume that no one wants to have someone just be like, this is stupid, I want it this way, blah. And I don't know, I just, and I know that I can act that way sometimes if I just get in a bad mood when I'm playing some campaigns. So I apologize if that's the case. Overall, though, every campaign I've played, I've been pretty happy with. Even in Slavers, again, it's just not my style of play, of just those long macro, spend 2 hours, you know, I just not, that's not how I like to play that much. But this mission, on the other hand, it didn't take that long. I had an idea of how to defend because I played this mission before, so being able to, you know, not have to rebuild several times because I got wiped out by some attacks that came from the direction I didn't expect, I could build up battlecruisers rather quick. And now we're here. So we've taken out the Daylam base. I say Daylam because that's what I assume. That's just, they are Daylam Protoss. They're from Shakuris, and they're part of the High Templar, Dark Templar combine, if you will. One thing I wanted to point this out before is I like how Gradius has sort of created his own idea of what the Protoss military ranks are. I like that. I like when people take that initiative to, like, add some extra lore that doesn't really conflict with already exists, but it's just a neat little... It's just like neat little lore tidbits, and I think that's a really cool addition to the StarCraft universe in general. All right, and here we are. We're cleaning up the Annalene base now, and if I have to, I'll swing down and clear out the whole coastline. But overall, not necessary. I like the idea of having to use those Hercules, even though I didn't. So I don't know. I guess my opinion is, there's no way you can really force the player to use those Hercules. Oh, that's a mothership. Okay, well, there's the, he got a little frame rate issue there when that, black hole popped out, but I like the idea of using Hercules and the fact that he supplied the Hercules right away so that you could use them to cross the river, but I just sort of circumvented that. Maybe I should have played, I assume as intended it's you're supposed to drop, but I feel that, oh, come on, I just used all my energy. I just used all my energy to use Yamato, so now I don't have that energy anymore when this is over. But what I was saying was, you can't force the player to drop. That's the thing. You know, the best you can hope for is the player recognizes, now let's Yamato this asshole. You can't force the player to do what you want, unless maybe it's like you can't make any air units. Kind of like that Brood War mission, or was it the Zerg campaign when you're on Shakuris and you're killing and you're destroying Telematros. So I feel kind of bad because there's really no way that you can tell the player, like, you have to drop, because that's how this mission was built as intended. So I really like Battlecruisers, so that's how I'm playing this mission, but obviously Hercules is a really interesting unit. I love how fast they drop things. Like, it's like a machine gun of dropping Marines out of them. But I can finish this mission quicker with Battlecruisers, I feel, so that's partially why I went Battlecruisers. I'm just rambling about about God knows what, just like, oh, the mission is intended, blah, 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 but I don't know, how can you contest mass battlecruisers with science vessels that can heal them? It's so fun. And in StarCraft II, the mission where you get battlecruisers is way, way, way more tedious than this one, that's for sure. This mission isn't tedious at all. I really enjoy it. It's very fun. The attacks can be challenging. And this is one mission where I feel like I would be interested in trying it on Brutal. Missions that I would not want to try on Brutal, clearly Mission 5, and probably not Mission 3. Missions 2 and 3 might be a little too challenging on Brutal as well. Both pretty hard on just the hard difficulty, whereas on Brutal, I don't know. But like this one and the previous mission on Brutal, I'd be interested in trying, because I feel like they're balanced about what StarCraft II campaigns on hard and brutal were. There we go, we didn't have to destroy all those extra cannons. That's good.
We've got more incoming. We're not going to survive this next wave.
I will hold them back for as long as I can. There is little else you can do here. Go warn Niliok and Voronor.
But you're not.
Go. If I can give Voronor enough time to fortify our last entrenchment, then you all might have a chance. I shall hold this position with my life. Niliok, I am sorry, old friend.
Damn!
Helios! Another mighty soul vanquished by these blasted humans. By a doom, the 19th Auxiliary shall have retribution for this anathema. Seems our agreement is now annulled, Voronor. Considering that we are all about to be vanquished upon this frozen backwater.
If you have been willing to work with us instead of stabbing us in the spine, none of this would be happening. You deserve whatever manner of death is coming for us.
Well, that's pretty much true. I have to agree with Voronor, but again, I, as I've said in previous missions, I like the storytelling to the point where I can see how different players would think differently. Different players still think that Meliak had the right intentions of trying to stop the Annalim from the get-go, and also Meliak's just kind of a cool hero in general. So, yeah, that's about all I have to say about this. I rambled a lot about the map-making meta in general this mission, but I really wanted to take some time to talk about it because I certainly sounded like an asshole in some of the previous missions, and I feel like it's a little unfair again, especially because I've played these missions before, so I'm able to look at it with a bit more of a critical eye than I would have the first go-around. Anyway, this has been JayBarino. The next mission is the last one. Then I have to pick a new custom campaign. I'm slowly being bled dry. There's not many more left, but there are a lot in active development, and I'm really excited. Some of the ones that are in active development are really, really cool, and I'm really looking forward to them. Specifically, Ivandel's third addition to his Perfect Soldiers trilogy, Abandonment, which I think is made by Hockleberry, and Annihilation, made by Dudesky, and then Ignos, which is Njordi's. I apologize if I'm missing anyone, but those four in particular I've been following very closely on SC2 Mapster, and I'm really, really excited. I'm not anticipating them, like, really soon or anything, but when they're done, I'm really, really looking forward to playing them. Anyway, this has been JayBarino, and I'll be finishing up this campaign next time. See you then. Thanks for watching. Bye.